Okay, here we go. This is Raging Rob making another video. It's probably going to spur a lot of controversy, but I got to do this. You know, that's what Raging Rob does. He spurs controversy. I start controversy. I start drama. I am a dramanoid. That's what I do. No, seriously, I expose the people that need exposure. That's what I do. This is going to probably stir a lot of heads. What can I say? Like I haven't stirred heads. Like I haven't turned heads before. Like I haven't got people to say things about me before. That's perfectly fine. Now, I'm going to start by saying I made a video about this 1.5 years ago. And the problems it created was enormous. Here we go again. But I seen a story, which I want to share. It happened back in Flint, Michigan. About 1.5 years ago, I made a video pretty much I was explaining the difference between child abuse and punishing your kids so they won't end up in the Department of Corrections. Maybe I stepped a little overboard and said, you know, maybe if you whip your kid's ass once in a while, they won't get out of line and they won't end up in the Department of Corrections and my taxes won't be taking care of them in prison someday. I might have said a little things off board, but it's clear. I'm 100% against child abuse. Absolutely. Don't condone it at all. Pedophilia, child abuse, 100% against it. Regardless of what any troller or hater against my channel says, they can say whatever they want. They can take my video and say whatever they want. You know who I'm talking about. You know who you are. The trollers, the haters, that like to take the things I say and put me on blast. Mister, I'm gonna spread your video everywhere. Go right ahead. Not gonna change the way I look at things, not gonna change my views. I'm gonna stick up for what's right. I'm gonna expose the crap that needs to be exposed, the trash. The Illuminati, the New World Order, the bad corporations, the bad people, the evil in this world, I'm going to put their ass on blast because they deserve it. So go ahead and do whatever you want with my video. But like I said 1.5 years ago, there's a difference between correcting your kids and child abuse. And I'm firm on that. There's this disturbing video floating around Facebook. You may have seen or not seen. Flint mother and 2 other faces charged after showing footage of a boy on their Facebook. So first off, why are they stupid enough to put it on Facebook in the first place? There's certain things I won't put on Facebook. There's certain personal things I won't put on Facebook or YouTube or Twitter. You know, using people's names or whatever. You gotta have a brain what you put on social blogging, because anybody can see it. So anyway, this mother and 2 others are charged with felony counts of child abuse for allegedly beating their kid with a belt 60 times. 60 times! Now in my eyes, regardless of what this boy did, maybe he's a little brat, maybe he needs a spanking or two, but this is clear child abuse. There ain't no doubt about it in my brain. 60 times with a belt is clear child abuse. I mean, that's ridiculous. I believe in correcting your kid so they won't end up in the Department of Corrections. But not to the point of child abuse. Let's say, you know, they said he got belted across the ass 60 times. I didn't see the video. I'm just going by what the news is saying. Which, you know, multimedia, these communist news networks, CNN, you can't trust everything they say. They like to put bullshit out there. Government-run radio stations, whatever. They like to fucking mix up shit. So I'm not going by... I'm just going by what it says here. 60 times. Well, obviously, 60 times with the belt, without a shadow of a doubt in my brain, is child abuse. Maybe 2-3 times would have been okay. Do I support belt across the ass? Well, it depends on the situation. I don't condone child abuse. When I was a kid, well, maybe I should put... Let me just say that my mom and dad, they corrected me. They corrected me when I got out of line. I got out of line a few times. They corrected me. They didn't ever abuse me. Regardless of what DJ Buie says, or regardless of what Truckers Against Pedophiles say, my parents never abused me. And I'm against 100% against child abuse. Whatever any idiot out there says, look at Rachel Rob, he supports beating your kid. You know, bullshit. Bullshit. Okay? I don't. I support correcting your kid, punishing your kid when they're wrong. Put them in line so they won't end up in the corrections. Teaching your kid right from wrong. I don't support child abuse. I don't support beating your kid. I don't support punching your kid in the face. You know, burning them with cigarettes. Leaving bruises and marks on their body. Bloodying them up. I mean, there's some sick shit out there I've seen. Floating around social media. Disgusting shit that I'm purely against. But then you have idiots that come against me. Well, look at Raging Mom. He's trying to justify child abuse. Bullshit. I gotta be very careful what I say, because I say the wrong thing, somebody's gonna come against me. So I gotta choose my words carefully. And regardless of what people think of my video, there's going to be a few idiots out there that's going to say I support child abuse, when I clearly just stated 5 times I don't support it. But there's going to be somebody out there. There's going to be somebody. I try to inform people. I try to inform them of the evil things that's going on in the world. And there's always... You can't get to everybody. There's always a couple people that just want to twist my words around. No matter what I say, no matter what I do, there's always a couple of jackasses out there. They're going to take what I say and twist it around. I was having problems with this with a certain group. Twisting things I say. So anyway, this mother, 2 others charged with, I lost a story on my iPod, iPhone. Somebody carjacked a taxi in Alabama. Jesus Christ. This world's all fucked up. Oh, I lost the story. But a year and a half ago, I made a video about this. There's a Facebook group out there called Truckers Against Pedophiles, which I'm getting tired of talking about them, because they're really up my ass. Or they were up my ass. No, I'm not a pedophile. But I'm just saying, about a year and a half ago, you know, I followed them on Facebook for a good 2 years. A long time. Before the incident happened. They put a story up on child abuse. You know, I just pretty much told them in a post, hey, you know, there's a difference between child abuse and correcting your kid. And they, you know, I might have said a couple things out of line. My fault. I admit when I'm wrong. Not really meaning when I'm... How do I say this? Not really thinking about what I was saying. Not really trying to... Trying to get a train of thought here. Sometimes I say things in the spur of the moment. You know, jokingly. I don't use the correct terminology. So anyway, Truckers Against Pedophiles, this group, I pretty much called him out on the post, and I explained to him, hey, you know, I don't support child abuse, but there's a difference between child abuse and correcting the kids. They got all ass bent about it, blocked me from their Facebook page. It just went back and forth for quite some time. Labeled me and slandered me. Rob Kinnison, remember Raging Rob? He supports child abuse. And it just went back and forth. Recently, here, week and a half ago, put out a video about, you know, I support the Tea Party. Anyway, I put video out week and a half ago, pretty much coming against the Tea Party for something else they did. I forgot what it was. Americans Against the Tea Party was the name of the Facebook group that I'm against, and I made a video against them. These anti-constitutionalists support tyrannical laws. I just called them out on their action, and in the video I stated, you know, I hate to say this again, but I gotta get a point across. I dated a 16-year-old when I was 19, 20, whatever. But anyway, they used that against me, saying, oh, now he's admitting the pedophilia. It's ridiculous. Going back and forth. It's bullshit. The point is, my haters are gonna say and do whatever they're gonna say and do against me. I can't really control them. I can inform them. I can put out the truth. I can put out what I think is right. There's always going to be a couple idiots that come against me, no matter what. And they're going to be firm on their ideas. So anyway, there's a difference between child abuse and correcting your kids. I firmly believe that. And it depends on the situation. Civil disobedience, New York gun owners will likely refuse to register firearms. Well, in the state of Arizona, I don't have to register. But just keep in mind, a background check is a gun registration. I did a background check, so my guns are registered. Because they've been caught. The ATF takes the registrations, they collect the information, but I'm not sure about it, the ATF or the people that themselves that do the background check. It is a felony for the person doing the background check to give out the information other than the ATF. That is federal law. But these people that give out the background checks, they've been caught abusing it. So that's why I say a background check is a registration. So technically, in the state of Arizona, you legally don't have to register your guns, but I did a background check, so they have my information. Anyway, let's not get sidetracked. This is a little story I read. Alex Jones. New York gun owners are refusing to register firearms. Okay, so I'm against child abuse. Firmly against it. I was never abused as a child. My parents, they corrected me. I turned out fine. I might yell on the camera. I might swear and cuss a little bit. I don't get out of line. I maybe cross the line a little bit, but I stop myself. Regardless of what my haters say against me. I just had to put this out there. I'm not trying to mock anybody, but I had to clarify it. Some people won't get it. Maybe if society did a better job correcting their kids, we wouldn't have the swag, the thugs, the knockout games, and all the other trash. We wouldn't have this, you know, worshipping the crap on MTV and Hollywood. Now, I'm a Call of Duty fan, but there's some nuts out there that don't know the difference between reality and fiction. So you got that crowd too that takes everything they see on video games and think it's reality. No, I don't glorify violence. Only in video games. people will use it against me, say it's a bad thing. I know the difference between reality and fiction. All right, here's a story. So who's dumb enough to put it on Facebook in the first place? Stupid. And I put a comment down there saying, hey, you know, there's this guy on here, comment on there saying he totally agrees with this. I mean, you agree with belting your kids 60 times, you're sick in the head. I'm not going to say this guy's name. I'm going to keep his name confidential. But this idiot looks like a Macklemore. And I just put down a comment saying, hey, you know, I don't support 60 times, maybe once or twice is one thing. My comment I put down was, let's see what I, let me pull it up here. This is exactly what I said, word for word. I believe in punishing your kids so they won't end up in the criminal justice system, but I think 60 times is a bit much. Maybe two or three times with the belt across the ass will teach them. There you go. I used the word belt across the ass. Here we go. With the slander. Just jokingly, you know, not really meaning, trying to say beat your kids. I don't support beating your kids. Belt across the ass is just a figure of speech. But there's going to be some liberals out there. It's going to come against me. There's going to be some people out there. Well, this nutcase, he supports child abuse. So anyway, this person said he supports what the parents do. He supports a belt across the ass 60 times, which I don't. Once or twice is one thing. Just a couple of smacks, you know. I can't use the word smack. Oh gosh, I gotta watch the words I use because my haters will use it against me. Swaps across the ass, or swat. I shouldn't use the word ass, I should use the words buttocks. Some parents don't believe in even spanking, which, fine. But you have to put your kids in line. I mean, you have to punish your kids when they're wrong. They got to know the difference between right and wrong. Or they're going to end up like Trayvon Martin. Trayvon Martin didn't know the difference between right and wrong. He was trying to break into houses. The story that the media won't tell you, the burglary tools that was found in his book bag, and the security guard he tried to kill, and karma got him because he didn't have parents to correct him. As far as me and my brother, we've had our couple run-ins with the law, but we've never been in any trouble. We know the difference between right and wrong. I don't have any kids. I don't plan on having any kids. Not the way this world's going. I'm going to teach them right from wrong if I ever did have kids. So I just responded to this person's comment. It's clear you support child abuse. You Macklemore look-alike dildo. I bet you support gay marriage, too. Just being a smartass. Anybody gay out there? I'm sorry, I'm not trying to be offensive. Please forgive me. And somebody else posted a comment. My parents whipped me, and I love them to death, and thank them every day for who I am. My parents did the same. My parents never punched me in the face, or abused me, or left marks on my body, or bruises, or bloodied, or anything like that. My parents never did that. But if you ask DJ Buie, she's the one who came against me a year and a half ago. If you ask her, she thinks I was child abused. She thinks I was abused as a child, and I suffer mental illness from the abuses I suffered as a child. That's what DJ Buie says. If you ask her. Yeah. But she won't tell you the same reason she got terminated from YouTube is because she had a chat room on her site and was allowing teens to go in her chat room. And she was using teens to troll her haters. And once the teens came against her, she reported the teens to her parents, getting them in trouble. YouTube and a couple other people caught wind of what this evil bitch was doing, and her account got terminated on YouTube. Now, allegedly, she got her account back. I don't know. So these haters that want to hate me, just keep one thing in mind. We all have mistakes we make, including myself. We all have flaws. I got my own flaws. Everybody's got their own issues. Everybody's got their own problems. Look at your own flaws. Look at your own problems before you attack me. Because if you think you're perfect, you're wrong. And the same thing goes to that group, Truckers Against Pedophiles. I totally support what they're doing, going after the real creeps, the child molesters, the sex offenders that get out of prison. They want to inform the public when a sex offender moves into the neighborhood. I can support that. But they're outright going out slandering people. Not just me. I caught a couple other people out there. They're just outright slandering for the most dumbass things. I gotta finish this video up. My load is done. I gotta hurry up. Final thought. Truckers Against Pedophiles. I got their Facebook page suspended for the slander. I threatened them with a lawsuit. And I was going to go to Alex Jones and let them know what the hell was going on. They seemed to back down. They seemed to got the point. Because Facebook suspended them. Because I wrote a nice letter to Facebook. They were blocked on Facebook for a while, as far as I know. So this is Raging Rob. Subscribe to my channel if you're new. I am 100% against child abuse. I speak against the New World Order. I speak against the Illuminati and all the disgusting rats in the world. That's what my channel is about if you're new to my channel. My channel is not a hate channel. I'm trying to clean things up a little bit. I realize I've gotten out of line in the past. And let me just say this, I'm trying to clean up. I'm trying to clean myself up. I'm realizing what I'm doing. Some things I'm saying is wrong. I'm trying to clean my act up. Subscribe, follow, whatever. Peace.